The 39th session of the United Nations Human Rights Council is currently underway in Geneva. LTTE supporters of the Tamil diaspora gathered at the UNHRC headquarters yesterday to engage in a protest. Protesters were seen holding flags of the LTTE and photos of prominent members of the terrorist organization, including its late leader Prabhakaran. Meanwhile, addressing the 39th session of the UNHRC, the Executive Committee member of the World Patriotic Lankan Forum, Professor Channa Jayasumana, expressed views on the inception of the controversial concept of a separate land for the Tamil community.
Racism in Sri Lanka has led to violation of human rights in all Sri Lankans. Scholars including Professor Karthikesu Indrapala has pointed out that there were no permanent Tamil settlements in Sri Lanka before 13th century. When the Portuguese arrived in Sri Lanka, the Sinhalese people were the majority in the Jaffna Peninsula as well as rest of the country. The Dutch, who occupied the coastal areas of the country around 1650, brought the Vellala Tamils from present Tamil Nadu for their tobacco plantation in Jaffna. The English, who occupied the country in 1850, gave preferences to the Vellara Tamils. In 1833, when the Legislative Assembly was established, the British government appointed one Sinhala and one Tamil-speaking person to represent the communities without any semblance to democracy, ignoring that the Sinhalese constitute 75% of the population with a history of more than 2,000 years and Tamil-speaking people who constitute around 10% of the population with a history not going back to more than 200 years. The Tamil Vellara leaders aspired to be the leaders of the country under the auspices of the British. In 1931, the British introduced universal franchise and the Vellala leaders found that they could not become the leaders of Sri Lanka. Then they wanted to become the rulers of the northern and eastern province. This was the beginning of the separatist movement. Thus, the Tamil separatist movement sprang up not because of any injustice to the Tamil-speaking people, but due to the fact that the Vellala Tamils could not become the leaders of the entire country. In 2009, the entire Tamil racist movement was defeated and there is nothing to talk further as the military solution given in Nandikadal is nothing but a political solution. Studying genuine history shows there is no ethnic problem in Sri Lanka.
Meanwhile, Rear Admiral Sarath Veerasekara expressed views to media yesterday ahead of his departure to Geneva tonight to address the 39th session of the UNHRC.
The President is scheduled to go to New York in a while and he will also be presenting some proposals. We have never committed war crimes to worry about watering down any allegations or solving matters diplomatically. The President should point out that Resolution 30/1 was co-sponsored without his or Cabinet's approval.